So I asked this of a lot of prep school coaches, John, and you had the privilege to coach some NBA players during your time at IMG. Tell me who those guys were and tell me what made them NBA players versus non-NBA players.
Well, obviously talent. You've got to be talented. You got to be skilled. And, you know, because I've had a couple kids that are, you know, everyone says, oh, you got to work hard. And I've got some kids that'll outwork these guys sometimes. They just are just relentless. They're just not good. They're just not talented. But there's a mindset that you have to have. I think that that these guys had, you know, the Jonathan Isaacs and, you know, Anthony Simons and those guys that just were just a little bit different. And they worked harder. They did something really, really good. And, you know, that was their strength. But you have to be talented. You have to be skilled. You have to, you know, you can't be 5'10 and be lights out shooter. And you have to be great at something you do. And you have to be a little bit more skilled than somebody else, talented. But Mike James was a player for us at Duquesne. It wasn't for us. He was before our time. And when we got to Duquesne, we would talk to the maintenance guys. And they would say on a Friday night at 11 o'clock, you hear the ball bouncing. And you'd go in the gym and you would see Mike James in there on a Friday night or a Saturday night. And instead of being out, you know, having fun, you know, just relaxing, he was working. And he made himself. He was a good player, you know, in Duquesne. But he became a great player and, you know, won a championship with Miami and then got that big guarantee contract in Toronto. And he told me once, I said, what do you do? How do you do this? How do you get it? He said, you have to have animal. Mm-hmm. I said, animal. He said, yes. He said, coach, they're trying to take my job. Think about that. Go to work every day and somebody's trying to steal from you and take your job away from you. How are you going to fight for your family and your house and your kids? What are you going to do? He said, on my team, there's a guy, he's trying to take my job. And when I'm playing against my opponent, he's trying to take my job. He's trying to beat me. He's trying to take something from me. He said, so I always had it in my head about telling kids, see if they have that animal in them. You have to have, there's something different about them, those kids, that you have to have that it thing. You know, people talk about it. Well, that it is that animal. I got to go out there and this is business. This is, you know, they're trying to steal, take my car, my wife, my house and put me out and make me homeless. And they're not going to do it. You know, so that was his way of, communicating that to us. I thought it was great.
Oh, I love that. I love that. Another thing is sickness. I've heard that from Joe Mantegna at Blair Academy.
You're possessed yeah. with it. And that's all you want, you know? But yeah, there's just kids out there that you can tell, you know, I recruited Gordon Hayward. I never thought Gordon Hayward would be a pro. Never thought he would be a pro though. There's so many guys, you know, that I recruited and we didn't get that I would. Kawhi Leonard, I got an opportunity to recruit Kawhi Leonard. I never thought he'd be this good. Never, ever in high school, you know. Now, Klay Thompson, we recruited Klay. I thought we thought he was special. And you know, we called him a point forward back in 2006 or whatever it was, a point forward. He could play all four positions for us. You know, it was fun recruiting Klay. He was different, very different.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's cool.